Good morning, my dear student. Today the same unit fundamental operations. So exercise 2A. I continue the exercise. Before classes in fundamental operation, adding the expressions and subtract the expressions. So everything you seen in the before class, addition and subtraction both having the common terms are subtracted. Common terms are added. Added means the variable except the variable, the coefficient, numerical coefficient only added and subtracted. In subtraction, the second number will be after subtraction symbol, the after number only, the all the sign will be changed. This is are the only concept of the exercise. Okay, now I continue that sixth sum, second subdivision, first division you take it as a homework. Subtract 2a cube minus 4a square plus 13 from the sum of 7a cube plus 3a plus 7 and 3a cube minus 3a square plus 4a plus 5. So question is the subtract this number from the sum of these two number. So sum of these two expression, first you find the sum of these two expression, you got one answer, that answer will be from to subtract this number. Okay, first you take the sum of this two expression, I take this two expression is equal to 7a cube plus 3a plus 7 plus 3a cube minus 3a square plus 4a plus 5. So addition means no changes any sign. So straightly you take the plus sign only. Now you will add the like terms only. A cube and a cube is there. So coefficients are added. 7 plus 3a cube plus the next one is a term. 3a and 4a is there. So 3 plus 4a plus next one is constant term is there. So 7 plus 5, you get 7 plus 5 constant. One more number is there, a square, but there is no a square in the first number. So we take only one a square term minus 3a square. Now add the coefficient, 7 plus 3 is the 10a cube. Next one a square term you write minus 3a square. The next one 3 plus 4, 7a plus 12. So this is the answer of the sum of the expression. So you got the sum answer. After that, the sum is the from number. So first you write the sum number minus the first number is 2a cube minus 4a square plus 13. So after minus symbol, the expression will be given bracket because the minus sign, the subtraction will take place for the second number. Every sign will be changed in the opposite sign. So 10a cube minus 3a square plus 7a plus 12. This minus is applicable for the expression. The 2a cube is minus 2a cube minus 4a square remains 10 plus 4a square plus will be changed to minus. So minus 13. Now the common terms are combined together. 10 minus 2a cube minus 3 plus 4a square and 7a is not to pair anything. So 7a straightly 12 minus 13. 10 minus 2 8a cube minus 3 plus 4a square 7a 12 minus 13 minus 1. So this is the answer, children. So one more thing, in this class the sixth sum up to sum only I do in this page. So I put the continue. The continue will be in the next page. I put the continue. So you continue and till this this is the sixth sum. So everyone copy down this. Now I go for the seventh one. What should be subtracted from this number to get this number? Okay, what should be subtracted from this expression to get this expression? Already know that sum in before classes and before 6th standard, sorry, 7th standard also you study like this. So let x be the number because there is no number will be given. Some number from this number subtracted that number, you get answer is this one. So x is the unknown number you take. Now from number will be write first minus this x equal to get number. Now 14x power 4 minus 3x cube plus 25x minus 42. This term, this expression fully comes to the left hand side. This minus x goes to the right hand side, means plus x will be take. This number comes this side, means every plus number will be in negative and negative number will be in plus. So 3x power 4 minus 3x power 4. 17x cube comes this side. So minus 17x cube minus 12 comes this side plus 12x minus 65 is come this side plus 65 equal to x. Now combine the like terms. 14 minus 3 get 11 x power 4. Minus 3 minus 17, so minus 20 x cube. 25 plus 12 you get 37 x. Minus 42 plus 65 you get plus 23 equal to x. So you find the x value. This is the answer for that question. The next one is 8th sum. How much smaller is 5x minus 8y plus 9z than 12x minus 10y minus 3z plus 16? So the question is, how much smaller is this number than this? So compared to this number, how much it is smaller? So from number is this one only. This is the bigger number. So expression 12x minus 10y minus 3z plus 16 is the bigger expression. First you write that. Subtracted the 5x minus 8y plus 9z. Afterwards, you take the minus inside of the bracket. 12x minus 10y minus 3z plus 16 minus 5x plus 8y minus 9z. Now 12 minus 5 get 7x minus 10y plus 8 minus 2y minus 3 and minus 9 minus 12z. Constant term only 1, so plus 16. So this is the answer. The next one. How much bigger is this number than this number? So how much bigger is this number? So this one is the bigger number compared to this. So first you write this number. Expression 7x square y square minus 16xy square minus 8x square y square minus of 3x minus 3x square plus 4x square y minus 9xy. Now the first number same. Minus into minus plus 3x square plus into minus minus x square 4x square y minus into minus plus 9xy. Now the common terms are added. So x square y, there is no x square y term. So only one x square y term. So straightly you write 7x square y term. The next one is x square y term having 2. So minus 8 minus 4 minus 12 x square y. The next xy square term. There is no other xy square term. So, minus 16 xy square term. X square term is also no like terms is there. So, plus 3 x square. And xy term also, there is no combined term. So, 9 x square xy. So, only the common is this two term. Not this. This minus 8 and minus 4 only having the like term. The remaining 3s, the rows are having no common like term. So only these two only combine together. Otherwise the remaining is same only you do the answer. The next one, 10th sum is very important sum. If the perimeter of a triangle is 4y minus 3x plus 2z centimeter and two sides of the triangle measure 4x plus 2y plus z centimeter and 3x plus 7y minus 2z centimeter, find the length of the third side of the triangle, because triangle having three side, two side measures is given, so two side of the length is given, and one more given is perimeter of a triangle is given. You know the perimeter of the triangle. So, first of all, you find the third side. So, let A, capital letter A, be the third side length. Okay, the perimeter of a triangle means equal to something is given. But perimeter of the triangle means the just the correct formula is three-sided added with together. You get the answer of the perimeter of the triangle. That means sum of all the three sides is called the perimeter of a triangle. So, sum of three sides is equal to this term. So, sum of three side means two side already given in your note, but third side is not to given in your sum. So, first two sums, first two side will be added, and the last one plus A you will put equal to the perimeter value. Now, you will add these two terms, two expression 4x plus 3x, you get 7x, 2y plus 7y, 9y, z minus 2z. Minus z plus a equal to 4y minus 3x plus 2z. Now you find only the third side, so a only. So every these three terms are goes that side. So 4y minus 3x plus 2z no changes, but 7 goes that side minus 7x, 9y goes that side minus 9y, z minus z goes that side plus z. Now you will like terms are added and subtracted. First of all, x term, minus 3 minus 7, so minus 10x, 4y minus 9y minus 5y, 2ez plus ez, 3ez. So the answer is the length of the third side is minus 10x minus 5y plus 3ez centimeter. So question is in centimeter, means answer also in centimeter. This is today class children. Everyone copy down this every sum in your class workbook. Only the sixth sum, first submission, only homework. So thank you children watching the video. So everyone ready for the second midterm test. Thank you children.